Not seem prepared for the magnitude of this moment.
Not at all. I mean, first, the man and the movement need to be held totally strictly accountable. The guy that did this and the movement that he represented needs to be held accountable on this. But to sort of step back and reflect a moment on this, everybody at this table's family and individuals and their ancestors have in some way been harmed by white supremacists over the years, whether it's Latinos, people of Jewish ancestry, women, Irish Catholics, Greeks, they've all been it. But even more so, I went to the new American History Museum of the American Revolution in Philly on Friday, and they have its beautiful place, and they have Washington's tent, right, that he lived in, basically, and operated out of for 5 years. And if you think about moments in our history, we haven't always honored that sacrifice that has been done by people. We've had interned Japanese. It took us 100 years before we banned slavery in our country. It took us another 100 years before we dealt with civil rights. Women didn't get the right to vote for 150 years. And even more so, I think, when you think about this, who shares responsibility in this? Who shares responsibility? It's not only the man, it's not only the movement, but anybody that points their fingers at Mexicans and Muslims shares responsibility.
Well, the president has to share responsibility. The fact is that through that campaign, he blew all kinds of whistles that those of us who grew up in the Jim Crow South, like I did, recognized immediately. It was just calling out to these white supremacists who then felt empowered by it. And the president now not calling them out. You know, he should listen to Nikki Haley, his now UN ambassador. She's the person who started bringing down Confederate monuments.
To the point.
And she did it so graciously and exactly the right tone after the killings at Mother Emanuel Church.
To the point of those emboldened by the president's words, David Duke on Friday night, Alex Castellanos. Here's what he said. We're determined to take our country back. We're going to fulfill the promises of Donald Trump. That's what we believed in. That's why we voted for Donald Trump. The president can't seem to find the words to denounce this.
There are